Thus, you made me into a storyteller, based on basically a fairy tale that we developed for the Audi Urban Future Award, and that fairy is called Away. What you see here, and I need, where is the pointer to move this? Technical assistance, please. Okay, so I just say next, or how does it work?
I'll find out.
Okay. This is the fairy tale Away, and if we go to the next picture, you will see a person driving, basically the situation as we have it today. Oh, here it is. Thank you. This is what we see today as the reality of driving. We do a lot of things. We call it Shiva driving. We smoke, we read, we shave, we talk, we read newspapers, we eat. But there's something on the horizon, like a digital world that you already can see coming up. And that digital world, that future that we are facing, might have 5 steps towards it. We call it to change, to digitalize, to clean, to mediate, or to communicate towards a digital technology and urban mobility. First, change. If the ozone hole in 1986, more or less, long time ago, changed the way how we consume, how we produce, how we move, then we see changes in an ecological sense, in an economical sense, in a social way, or for social conditions, in a cultural paradigm shift, and also in our aesthetics. All these 5 points are always to be considered when we talk about sustainability, the green bubble that we live in today. This Away situation means that there is a kind of a change in the digital world that introduces our everyday world, and we know movement or mobility in the virtual world from movies or TV series like Star Trek, here's teletransporting, or from Matrix, where we move into the virtual world. But we already do communicate as data bodies amongst each other or with our cars, for example, but also the cars and the bodies or the people and the environment, they all become kind of information tools, information networks, systems that exchange ideas, exchange information. And if all of this gets more and more part of our everyday life in urban contexts, we will have an electrified car, a pilotized driving car or piloted driving car, an assisted driving situation, and there's a constant car flow. There are no parked cars anymore. There's no stop and go. Cars communicate with each other. They have assistance systems. They know where they're going. And this also, of course, means we as people already start talking as our digital bodies with each other, amongst each other. And this is how it looks today. We have a physical body, but there is a whole kind of array, a layer of information that goes with us, that starts to communicate, that tells other people how we feel, which mode we are in, if we want to flirt, if we want to communicate with other people, if we need a certain protection level, if we have to erase certain biodata, and so forth. We already have institutions that mediate this and where we place our digital bodies to communicate. Facebook is one of the most known ones. We have walls that become kind of the pin walls where we put up our informations. We poke because we want to go and attach with somebody or we like something. All of this is not about being kind of innocent. This is about creating profiles about us, about what we like, what we think, what we hate, what we want to communicate outside. Third point, to clean. This digital tsunami that is entering or coming into our cities will take a lot of things away that we are taking for granted now. So you have the lights, the street lights, or actually the traffic lights, all this infrastructure that helps us to negotiate or navigate through the city. You have the digital car, and that car doesn't need all these systems anymore. The car knows where to stop or actually where to record other cars and actually maneuver around. That car senses when there are other people walking across the streets. So all these infrastructures that pollute, visually pollute our cities are away. Also, the car doesn't need light anymore. They know where to drive. We don't need infrastructure that's highlighted at night. So we can actually have our view back to the city again in the future. This picture shows that if we have assisted driving systems in the streets, in the cities, we can take lanes away and compress more traffic onto one lane because they're more efficient. So all of a sudden, we have more space inside the city. We have more pedestrian areas, or we have a possibility to extend the houses, to enlarge them for, let's say, systems to collect energy, solar systems, or to create more green in the cities, to have other forms of infrastructure and mobility systems in the city, to create cultural or social institutions. But also this digital tsunami will create a certain transparency into the building. So it's not only the extension outside, but we also have a view into the larger depth of buildings. We already know cars that photograph. And these cars then also, of course, generate a certain awareness of where privacy and public appearance lies, what we said earlier in the digital depths of the buildings. So there will be new forms of creating privacy again, as we know them now, by blurring facades in the streets on a digital or virtual reality of the city. Or the kind of the participants of mobility will be blurred and therefore privatized or, you know, kind of personalized in the city itself. So all these discussions about where do we stop off exposing us and where we need to be kind of protected already are in a constant negotiation process. Number four is mediate, and this is exactly what we're talking about. This layer of inside, outside, private and exposed, or engaged and retreat, creates a certain digital layer on the city, on the houses, on the streets, that then create a new relationship between inside and outside, private, public, exposed, involved, or private and kind of hold back. And this inside-outside relationship then, this is very difficult to read, if you have an intersection, also becomes kind of elastic when a car needs to stop quickly in this constant flow of information and mobility in the city. This is then how a street of the future could look like. It's an elastic street that has all of a sudden a new form of mobility system. It's not the car who is dominant anymore. It's mobility services that actually are the infrastructures of our city. We have mobility experience. The car goes away from driving to experiencing the city. The car might turn into a vehicle that is more of a mobility provider than the car ownership. We have mobility angels that help you to move actually from one mobility system to the other, let's say from a mass transportation to a car, from a car to a sidewalk or up a building. That's even more important for an aging society where mobility on a micro scale also becomes an issue. We have mobility service epicenters, basically a trust center that might be supported from a car manufacturer, then a mobility service provider. So they're all new forms of relationships and participatory systems that will change the way we look at the city. And the last one then, the communication part, is when the car really moves from being a driving machine to a being driven machine, or from a driving machine to an experience machine. Here you sit in the car, you look outside, and what it looks like, it shows here from the interior, you're sitting on the driver board or on the windshield, you look outside and you see the city as this kind of basically create your own city possibility through the negotiation or the fine-tuning of what you want to see. So the windshield can selectively block out or highlight what your interests are by driving through the city, and you create your own city. You don't drive through Berlin, through Tokyo, through Bielefeld, through Monza or something. You drive through your city that you are creating with your own interests and your status that you have at that moment. So in this case, you would drive through the city by just looking at nature in this kind of trees and sky, and basically you're wandering with the car through the city. In this case, you take real estate as your main source of information. You're looking for an apartment, you're looking for an office space. This is what you get highlighted on the screen. Everything else is kind of pushed in the back, made kind of invisible. And here again, the view through a possible street of the future. So if all of this comes true, there might be no ozone hole anymore. We might have discovered a new future. And this fairy tale also is, of course, presented in a book, a fairy tale book, which you can buy outside in the bookstore. Thank you.